all coming this morning, early morning on Monday. We're going to talk about GIS and mapping issues, but we're excited that you're here. A lot of empty seats right now, so I think we can be floating through the day. But once again, the GIS community in the Pittsburgh area and the Northeast, and some folks from all across the country too, that really come through, and we are we only have about 7 empty seats here. But that was my last comment. We sold some tickets. So we appreciate your support and good things to do. Just a quick safety minute for those of you that worked with us last year. We're not planning any fire drills for there.
We are not planning any fire drills.
I am glad we're not having any fire drills. So if the alarm should go off in case of a fire or other emergency, you're to evacuate the building through the doors behind me, go out onto the patio, and then we're all going to move to the southwest corner of the parking lot, and you can see I have a storm there over the for those of you that this may be your first visit to our facility, you're welcome. We are obviously right here in the auditorium, in the conference room, we have breakfast, we're conserving all our meals and breaks there. Patio social tent right outside there. Tonight's festivities have taken place. We can use the restroom. There's hallways on either side of the auditorium to take back the restroom in the main lobby. And we also have the small museum room up adjacent to registration. We'd like the folks to stop by and visit some of the displays to see what's possible. So we appreciate your support today. I really appreciate your comments. You could stop by and visit. Also, if you're feeling ill or have any reactions to food, let myself or another range staff member or member of the committee know. We have EMTs on site that can take care of any issue, and please don't be afraid to speak up. Just like to real quickly introduce our organizing committee for this year, and if each member can stand up when I say your name. I'd like to introduce my co-chair and partner in crime, John Kirkatic from Newport. Chris DiNardo, unfortunately, can't be here for some reason. He felt like going on a honeymoon to walk into court with kind of a GIS problem. I don't get it. But Chris is a new member of our committee this year. He's been a big help to us since taking over the whole trailer. Harold Lee Williams. Harold's been with us for second year. He's on the charter committee. Philip Levasseur from Cabin Oil and Gas. Phil's been helping us out this year, and he took care of the he and his wife actually took care of the program, so we appreciate that. Mike Mirabelli from Cabin Oil and Gas. Appreciate Mike's help as a member of our committee. Dr. Tom Spielberg from California University of Pennsylvania. Amy Simonson from National Fuel Gas, and myself, my name is Mark Lindgren. I'm with Range Resources, I'm the chair of the conference. Conferences can't happen with us. We have a number of people that are volunteering or volunteer to assist us with the conference. Cindy and Claudia helped out front with registration, and we thank those greatly. Cindy also helped with printing and pulling the programs, and Claudia did it for those name tags. Linda Lindsay, our photographer, and is hiding behind the full step out in the major. So please, Linda is a professional photographer too, but she's not working for us. So if she wants to pose, you please comply with her. She's really good at it. Liz Schaefer, who some of you met this morning. Liz is in our IT department, and she's helping us out with wireless connections and so forth with speakers. Ashley Donaldson from California University. Ashley's up front. So Ashley was passing out the social wire tickets. Her and Becky, who sound system too. So, also, we do have some wireless mics available if you're a person that needs to get out and jump around and talk like Dr. Palm does. Let us know, and those gentlemen will give you a wireless microphone. And I'd also last like to thank the Ranger Resources facility staff. They've done a great job keeping the building up and help clean up and everything back together here after the just a real quick thank you to our host and sponsors, obviously the Ranger Resources and John Abergat, our host, Michael Baker International, their gold medal sponsor this year. We thank you. Geospatial Corporation Silver. Rextag and Heart Energy is providing breakfast and lunch today. We appreciate the Wolbert is paying for our social tent. GeoCortex is paying for breakfast on day two. CoreLogic, Capital Oil and Gas, and Snack Hosts, Document Solutions. Contributed Social Hour, Spatial Energy, Door Prizes, EMAP, provider of lanyards, and California University is paying for the auditor. So we'd like to thank those. And as we go through the program, we'll get another opportunity to thank them and talk about their services. Just want to take one brief moment here to thank Ranger Resources for allowing us to host this when myself and colleague from the consulting firm came up with the idea of creating them just 2 years ago, back in 2012. One of the first people I had to talk to was our senior vice president, John Applegout, and John was very enthusiastic about it, big supporter of it, and unfortunately wasn't here last year for us to thank him. And he made a really nice Crystal Work Clinical Award and had Stone Minicum for Geologic Thing. I didn't get a chance to thank him, but sits up in his office and thank him for it. But Range makes a significant contribution to Energis and the GIP and the Planning Committee just by allowing us to have this facility. If we were to hold this in, I think that would cost three times as much. Food wouldn't be as good. It wouldn't be as comfortable. You'd be sitting in straight back to the hall chairs. We really appreciate the ability to have it here. And so this year, the committee wanted to thank John again for allowing us to hold the conference here. And we came up with the idea that instead of yet another plaque, and how many more plaques and awards do you need? We got a whole trophy case back here. We appreciate it. John suggested that the committee make a donation to the Washington County Food Bank, and we're here, and Amy Simonson, my colleague, is here to present John with a big check for them. Come up, John, and say a few words.
Let's go, sir.
Mainly in relation to the energy industry. Focus broadly on the energy industry. outlets here from distribution, transmission, mining groups, petroleum exploration, utilities. We have a really nice cross segment of our industry. And what we'd like to see are presentations from a variety of those segments and various software managers. For some conferences are focused on maybe just the transmission segment of the industry or the electrical segment of the industry or Autodesk or Esri software. We're open to everything and anything that's in there. So we hope to edify you all with the variety of talks we're going to have. And hopefully we can drive the conference by having more papers submitted by geologists, engineers, and surveyors. It seems we kind of get probably all the people say it's a GIS talk, you know, let the GIS people apply for the data. A lot, especially within the oil and gas companies, a lot of that geospatial work will be done by geologists and engineers. And you go back to your shops, talk up the conference, and maybe get some young engineers and geologists that even get out and do this type of thing. Please talk up the conference. Energis is run by the GITA Mid-Atlantic chapter, and I just want to give you a brief update on that. Just like Energis, we're in our second year of existence. This is our second year of producing the conference. And VR activities, we've increased GITA North American membership within the tri-state area. We initiated the Energis Scholarship Competition, which tomorrow we'll have a presentation, our grand prize winner. He's going to be here for a brief presentation and talk about his projects and go out on the other folks who have received scholarship following us. And we began our outreach and cooperation with the local ERISA chapter and the Appalachian Petroleum Users Group. So, you know, we're not going to play close to our best. We're here to help everyone, but hopefully everyone can choose for this conference. What do we need? We need volunteers, I'll tell you that. Help is needed for the discipline, for the following disciplines and committees. The conference committee suffered some attrition this year. We had two engineering firms, consulting firms that were involved in the conference last year, and they're unable to participate at this time. Now, so we kind of shrunk a little bit so we could use some help. So if anyone out there wants to help, has kind of feels you can do something, hey, I can improve on that, or Ellen Burns a group, you know, doesn't know what he's doing. Speak up, put up your hand, volunteer, we'll be glad to let you help us. But we do need help with advertising and social networking, webmaster or webmistress, ticket sales, database management, outreach and sponsors, scholarships, maybe recruiting keynote speakers or U.S. submitted papers. And actually, outreach and sponsors and vendors, that was one of the easiest portions of this conference, didn't you say, John? It was. We have excellent support from our sponsors. We really appreciate that. And the folks see the value of having a conference like this. It's regional. But our scholarship committee, recruiting keynote speakers, it was hard. I got one. So it took a while to get done. We appreciate the support, our support. And for viewers submitted papers, this is actually pretty hard to get a number of papers submitted for the conference. If we'd like to expand the conference, we need more content. That's the name of it. And I know you're going to say, hey, Mark, I'd like to help you, but I'm busy. You're busy, I'm busy, we're all busy. So, you know, please feel free to put up your hand, give us a hand. Appreciate it. Just give you a brief update on our parent organization, GITA North America. I currently serve as the president-elect of GITA, and we made a lot of progress in the last year. Last year, kind of gave you an update on how we were building the organization. We're building relationships with local chapters and creating the loss of staff, like other organizations who suffered during the recession. You know, a lot of sponsors went away, a lot of individual members went away, and going to do a demo on it, but please go ahead and take a look at our improved website, www.gita.org, and put behind the questions we have. There's actually a webinar out there to utilize the website for and we've increased the number of webinars and educational services available for members. In regards to individual members, in the next month or so, we're going to put off a membership drive for the organization's grassroots, reconnecting with lapsed members and reaching out to new ones. We will continue our coordination and delegate exchange with GITA Japan and GITA Australia and New Zealand. So we really are an international organization, and it's nice to cross quality in different areas and see what's of interest to geospatial professionals. And most significantly, we've actually begun new outreach to GIS communities in Kuwait, the United Kingdom, and as well as working just the way at the local level, we're working with the local ERISA group and the local hub group. At the national level, we work on the Running Alliance and some other groups. Our main focus is the GITA Oil and Gas Conference, which has also been rolled into Pipeline Week. And what's that? That is going to expand our offerings to our members by joining the pods. We'll do some joint conferences. We're in Houston, Texas, October 27th through October 30. The conference is actually 28, 29, 30. 27th is a golf tournament to benefit the GITA scholarship tournament. We're the voice of the geospatial professionals in the utility transmission and exploration. If you decide to join with us, you get a lot of value from educational services. We put out every month from now, there's an online webinar, publishing white papers, recorded lectures, conference proceedings, research papers, so on like that. With the new website especially, it works sort of like LinkedIn. You can go in and create a user profile, put your resume on there, and then you can start keeping track of everything you do. So you can log in, have your energy for a few days. All those points get totaled up, and then you can use it for GISP certification, recertification. So it creates an online CV, basically. For instance, last year's Energist proceedings were online. If you didn't attend last year, you've seen a knockout presentation on the presentation by my boss, Bill Zaborski, who was the keynote speaker last year. He spoke about the development of Marcellus Shale and exploration. Really excellent talk. That's all online. With help of videographers, they combine the actual PowerPoints that our presenters submit along with my video. Again, at the national level, we have opportunities for volunteer service. Put up your hand, let me know, give me a business card, get in touch with people that need help, that need help within the organization. And that includes help on board of directors, and we need representatives to serve on the GISCI board, NGAC, federal geospatial agencies, and many other regional and federal geospatial facilities. We get contacted, hey, can you send a representative to this meeting, can you send a representative to that meeting? We can only do so much with a limited amount of volunteers and candidates. Another benefit is your opportunity for career enhancement. We're looking for geospatial professionals to obviously present at various conferences, present at Allied Associations conferences, for instance. The Common Ground Alliance wants us to provide speakers for their conferences. something you're interested or you'd like to learn more, we are continuing to discount for new or lapsed members, some folks that enrolled via the ticket purchase for Energis, which gave you 50% off on your membership. We're going to extend that until September 30th. We go through the ticketing process, just enter Energis 50. And see me. Just want to kind of walk through some conference procedures real quickly here and make the agenda for today. As far as procedures, any speakers there that are on deck, I would ask that you sit to the right of the podium here. This way you're ready to go, and you can, if you need, you can switch out laptops. If anyone needs a wireless microphone, let me know. Moderators, they introduce the speaker, we're also going to serve as a timekeeper. They're going to be sitting right here in front of the podium, so you know as the speakers keep an eye on the time, they will flag it down, keep it on track. This year, we've added a new twist to the conference. We've got a request to offer some vendor showcases. Also, last year I sent out, I requested folks fill out a survey. Did you believe in, what did you like about the conference, what didn't you like about the conference, what do we need to do to improve? And the biggest comment was, I need more time to socialize, talk. My colleagues talk to the sales reps, talk to the sponsors, and so came up with the idea of creating social hour for that, so we're going to start social hour about 4:20. Who knows how long we've got, maybe 6, maybe 6:30, but there's never a good time to do it with them. But as you each register, you should have got some drink tickets. If you didn't, see me, see one of the ladies out front, and I'll help you out with that. Some beverages out there in addition to soft drinks and what's important. Also, so we're looking forward to that. The only change in the survey system, what we're going to do this year, we're going to do Survey Monkey and get a survey out to everyone. I appreciate the feedback afterwards. If you think it's fabulous, let me know that for sure. I'll forward those to John. But we want your feedback because the conference can only continue if it's providing the data and the information and the value that we can see out there. So we appreciate it. Next, let me introduce our keynote speaker. On the committee, we're looking for a web-based GIS guru to come talk to us, and we're digging around. I've contacted a lot of people. There's a lot of people out there on the internet doing a lot of great work. But I don't know if the conference isn't big enough, or they didn't know who the owner was, but yeah, I couldn't even get a phone call back. Digging through, I came across Kepler Software, and they do some fabulous knockout work. Website really impressed me, the work they do, and the way they have a really novel way of marketing their software, and actually giving it away. Basic proof, giving it away. I'll talk about that a little bit. I played around with it, so I contacted their sales and marketing department. They hooked me up right away, and Juan jumped at the opportunity to come speak to us about handling data. And it might be a little bit different than what you think, because a lot of times we're handling so much data, and I get this issue a lot, I'm sure a lot of you do. Somebody wants to show so much stuff on a map, you cannot do it. Sometimes I tell people, a map is not the way to show this data. And my colleague Chris Pond was talking about this last week. We need to, sometimes games are better, charts, presentations, and sometimes mixing a map. That's the way to show the data. But just cramming it all on a map doesn't work. And I see a lot of heads bobbing up and down, so I know some of you folks work for somebody like I do. Okay. So, without further ado, I kind of set things up while I introduce Quan. Quan Vu is the Director of Technical Product Marketing at Wiz Software. He works with customers around the world to help people see and understand data. He's an industry leader in GIS, business intelligence, navigation, and location-based technology. He has a 25-year track record in first-to-market business development and next-generation convergence across multiple industry and market sectors. Prior to his role at Tableau, he held executive roles at Broadmap, Teleatlas, and Infogroup. He has a history of success in fast-paced changes.